cute.
Aren't you beautiful? And who's this?
This is my Twitter winner.
Yes,
I did a contest on Twitter, and Gina won.
Are the winner? Well, it's a pleasure to meet you. Nice. Thank you for joining us with Fashion 2.0.
I figured it was apropos because it's all about being online, and this is all about social media, and so she won.
Absolutely. Welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you for being here.
Thank you for having me.
Do you use social media in terms of finding your personal style? Do you look for inspiration online?
I actually like to inspire online. My Twitter is really about health, well-being. All my followers are really happy, healthy people, or people who want to be healthy, or people who are looking for inspiration. And I have a really great relationship with my Twitter followers, my tweeps, as I call them.
Oh, amazing. But now, a question for you. You have absolutely gorgeous skin. Do you find tips for online, or do you just have your own skin regimen that you've always carefully followed? For a red carpet especially, to have that glowing radiant skin is really beautiful.
Well, I think it's very important that you live what you preach. So I really tweet about what I do in my life, what I have found that works, and what I have found that doesn't work. I call people out when they're pushing a product that doesn't work.
Right. So there's sort of that credibility there.
Yes. I think it's very important to have a responsibility to your followers.
Yeah, especially there's so many people now representing brands, and so you have to really believe in the brand.
Absolutely.
Can you tell us just a little bit about what you're wearing this evening?
Absolutely. What do you want me to start with? My shoes are as a Daniella. So there they are there.
Love them.
They're beautiful, aren't they? Like I saw them, I said, okay, that's them.
Yeah.
And there was like,
winner.
When you see a guy that you really like and there's that chemistry, we had chemistry, me and these shoes.
They were winking at you.
They were more than winking. And then the dress is Nicole Miller. The bag is Louis Vuitton. My watch is Frank Mueller. And my ring was a Cavalli that my boyfriend popped out the fake stone and put a real stone in. So. Yeah, I know, right? He's a designer in his own right. If he wasn't a hockey player, I'd think he was gay.
Well, you know what? He has good taste in,
or maybe
beard,
I should,
in jewelry.
Maybe I should say if he wasn't dating me, I would think he was gay.
Yeah.
Because he just has this fabulous design eye that all my wonderful gay friends have. So, yeah. So he popped the stone out and put a real one in.
It's awesome. A quick question for you. How did you win the contest? What got you here tonight?
She gave a smile.
Wow.
It was the best smile. Picture of the best smile.
Amazing. Well, thank you both. So nice
thank
to
you.
See you here.
Thank you.
It's Fashion 2.0. This is our camera right here. Can you tell us a little bit about how you picked your outfit tonight and if social media played any role in that?
I think I was going for something that was somewhat dressy but still comfortable. I'm a girl that likes menswear, so I went for a shirt dress. Kind of has a little bit of tuxedo detailing.
Absolutely, very unisexy.
Yeah, very unisexy. Doesn't need a lot of accessorizing and just pretty simple. Simple and chic.
And did you do your own hair and makeup?
I did.
Do you pick up little tips and tricks on Pinterest and Instagram?
I do. I'm always on all the blogs and Instagram, and I'm always checking out ideas online. I love to look at the vlogs and get tips on how to do my makeup and hair all the time.
I mean, I'm sure at Ebony you're also giving tips, but
yes.
There's so much information out there.
Yeah, you can always keep things fresh, and you can always learn something new.
Absolutely. And now the lip color, how did you pick it?
It's like a fusion of two different shades. One is like a MAC lip gloss, and then the other is like a matte wine lipstick. And I just kind of combined one. It's something that was, gave a little bit of an evening feel, but still felt funky.
Right. Like a little lip cocktail.
Yeah.
And the lashes, too. I love the lashes.
Thank you. I mean, these are just mascara.
What mascara?
What am I using? It's a Givenchy mascara. Oh,
amazing. Okay, and then let's hear... Who do you look for style inspiration when you go online? Whose feeds are you constantly looking for? It could be a brand, a celebrity, a friend of yours.
It changes. I don't really have one specific person, but I will say, I love to look at just regular girls. You know, I love to look at regular girls and see what they're wearing. I think street style is such a big thing, so I'm more so look to the streets to see what the, you know, what the kids are doing.
That's
to kind
right.
of get ideas.
That's right. And is there anything you have on, from your hairspray to your nail polish, that you bought online?
That I bought online? My shoes, actually.
And where did you get them? The
YSL shoes. I got them at Saks online.
And so you know your size. You know that your size in that brand.
I do. Shoes, I'm always pretty easy to buy online. I know my size in that brand, and I usually don't have any issues with that. Clothing sometimes gets a little tricky.
And have you taken a selfie of this look yet?
Not yet.
You intend to tonight?
I do. My phone is dying, so I need to charge, and then I'll be sure to do the selfie.
Okay, well, thank you for joining us. It was such a pleasure to meet you. I hope
thank
you enjoyed
you very
the awards.
Nice meeting you as well. Thanks
Bye-bye.
So much. Bye.
Thank you so much, everyone, for joining us tonight at Fashion 2.0, Style Coalition's Tech Meets Fashion Award Show. I'm Lauren Casenza, a Style Coalition blogger from Divalicious Blog, and I'm so excited to be bringing you everything live from the red carpet. Thank you. And keep watching, because we've got some good red carpet walkers coming up soon. For joining us this evening.
Thanks for having me.
Can you tell us a little bit about your outfit this evening and where you got your, sort of your style inspiration?
Yeah, my dress is from Maj and my shoes are Manolo Blahnik. My shoes are incredibly comfortable. Yeah, they're carry shoes. And I think they just, you know, I'm presenting tonight and I want it to be comfortable, so Manolo makes the most comfortable heels.
And then a little bit about your beauty look.
I always go with a red lip and just pretty much otherwise natural makeup.
Do you get style and beauty inspiration from social media, Pinterest?
Oh, all the time. Instagram, Pinterest, blogs, everything.
Who do you follow, whether it be a friend or a celebrity or a brand? Who do you have to see what they're doing next?
I would say Blair from Atlantic Pacific.
Amazing. Yeah. You haven't heard that yet. Okay, and then also, is there anything that you've been wearing tonight or that you've gotten recently that you've purchased online?
Yes, my earrings are BaubleBar.
Oh,
amazing.
Yes.
So I work for them. I was their fourth hire, and I'm presenting them as the Visionary Award tonight.
I'm a huge fan.
Oh,
huge
good.
Fan.
I'm so glad.
Yes, and so, okay, so you bought the earrings online, and mm-hmm. but are you a big online shopper, or do you like to go into stores and try on?
I'm a big online shopper. I just don't have time to go to stores all the time. I love shopping, but realistically, online's where it's at.
That's right. It's yeah. the future, right?
Yeah.
And have you taken a selfie yet tonight?
I have.
You have? Yes. And where did you post? What's your social media outlet of choice?
Instagram.
Instagram's yeah. number one. Are you on Snapchat too?
Yes.
And what are your thoughts on wearable tech?
I think it's really cool. I think that people need to figure out how to make it cute though. You know, there's so many great things, but no one's really nailed it in terms of aesthetics.
You think it's a little bit still bulky a bit?
Yeah.
It has a way to go, but yeah. it's a first round of that type of technology.
I think it's really cool.
Yeah, it's kind of the future. Would you, do you want jewelry that tells you if you've gotten a tweet or a text, or do you not
want to
know?
I want to know how many steps I've taken. I don't want to know if I've gotten a tweet or a text.
Yeah. So more like active.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. All right. Yeah. Well, we'll have to let people who are working in that sector know. But yeah. Thank you so much for joining us tonight.
You.
Enjoy the award. Absolute pleasure. Thank you for joining us. We won't take up too much of your time. Just wanted to ask you a little bit about your use of social media and sort of where you get inspiration.
You know, it used to be that I got all my inspiration from Europe and from the streets of Europe. And I used to think that, and it's something I'm going to talk about tonight in my speech, I used to think I was this genius, like mining gold on the streets of Milan, the streets of Paris, Antwerp, Dusseldorf, wherever it was. And then all of a sudden, my consumer was getting the same information that I was getting as quickly as I was getting it, and she was demanding product that quickly. So the awareness, the fact that you can live stream fashion shows, the fact that between Pinterest and Instagram, that she's seen everything, has completely changed my life. it's made me have to be smarter and faster and much more creative.
Right. And do you do selfies?
You know, it's funny. I am of a different generation, and my wife is a Instagram nut, and she lives, eats, and breathes it. I'm a very private person, and I when I came back and reinvented myself as a designer, I reinvented myself as a designer for young women, and I'm older, and I'm careful with how I use my image and what I do.
Their lines of privacy.
You know, to take pictures of lobster risotto is not my thing.
I hear you. Although sometimes it's enjoyable for some.
It is.
And a question about the future of technology, because you sort of said how technology, the change in technology, have sort of changed how you have to look at your business and your consumer. What do you think about wearable tech? Does someone who's as busy as you want to wear a bracelet or a watch that tells you you've gotten 5 tweets and 2 text messages, or do you not want to know?
I don't know the answer yet because it's new. You know, did I ever think that I would want to have my phone with me all the time, that I'd want to wake up and look at my phone? The answer would have been no. But it's an addiction, and human beings are wired for addiction. So do I think I'm going to want to wear wearable tech and look at my shoes and have them tell me when an appointment is? Yeah, probably. You know, I get in my car today, and everything in my car is communication, it's technology, and I like it. And I don't want a car that doesn't have technology. And I'm ready to walk in my house and say, warmer, colder, lights. And I think it's here.
And is there ever a time you want to break from technology? Do you ever need a little bit of a break to get your creative juices flowing?
Yeah, I think that's a great question. I think that, first of all, I need my personal time. I'm a horseman, and when I'm with my horses and riding horses and I'm in the woods, I don't want to be bothered with technology. And I think there are times on the weekend when you do need to get away, you need to shut your phone off. And I also think that I think we all need private time.
Well, thank you so much for your time this
thank
evening,
you.
And
nice
I hope
to
you
see
enjoy
you.
The awards.
Thank
this
you.
Is really great.
Bye-bye.
Thank you so much. From Mashable. I follow you on all my Twitter, on Facebook. I love Mashable.
Good. That's great to hear.
Can you tell us a little bit about how you picked your outfit for the evening?
You know, I stopped into the Rent the Runway shop in Flatiron, and I wanted something fun, funky, colorful. I love a graphic print, so I went with Clover
amazing.
Canyon.
It looks amazing, and it's so happy.
Thank
it's
you.
So spring.
It's very happy, despite the weather outside.
It's coming. It's coming.
Yes, it's coming. Here's
now,
crossed.
So Rent the Runway, obviously, it was originally an online destination.
Yes.
Now there's some a physical space that you can try things on. Do you prefer to try things on and shop in person, or do you like to online shop?
I get a little bit overwhelmed online. There's so many options, and it's really nice to be able to feel all the fabrics and actually figure, I'm tall, so being able to know if the regular length is going to be long enough, so being able to try it on and actually see. It's definitely nice to feel it. Yeah.
And what about hair and makeup?
I did a little bit of dry bar action today, did my own makeup.
Very nice work.
Very simple.
Very natural.
Yeah, thank you.
Do you get tips from Pinterest and Instagram on beauty?
I do. I tend to not be very crafty with hair and makeup, though, so I think that's better left to the experts, though I admire the DIY crowd that exists on Pinterest.
Like braids and all of that.
Yeah, I could never pull that off.
And are you someone who takes a lot of selfies? Are you a selfie person?
Not a big selfie person, no.
Favorite Instagram filter?
I like to mix it up. I actually don't really use many Instagram filters. I use a couple other apps and tinker with all the settings.
Right. Okay, and then one last thing. Is there anything that you're wearing this evening that you've purchased online, that you actually physically purchase, not the Rent the Runway dress? Even to be your hairspray.
Just online.
Nail polish.
Trish McAvoy mascara.
Okay, your mascara. And then you applied yourself as well.
I did. I applied myself.
One other thing. We want to ask you, too, about wearable tech.
Yes.
Yay or nay for you?
I think it's a big yay. I'm not wearing it tonight, but I have the Fitbit that measures the heart rate.
So. All right, well, thank you so much for your time.
Thank you so much.
good to see you. What's
man
going on?
Man of the hour.
M-O-T-H. Hashtag M-O-T-H. Yeah,
man of the hour. Now, question for you. Yes. We asked a lot of people tonight where they get their inspiration. Do they look follow people's feeds? But a lot of people now, obviously, are looking to you for that inspiration.
My God, really? That's nerve-wracking. The pressure is on for sure. I don't know if I do. I feel like anytime I find somebody inspiring, it's because I sense or smell or I feel an authenticity that's not fabricated. I think that social media allows people to even fabricate a fabulous life that ultimately becomes transparent that it's not that fabulous. But when I'm really taken with somebody, I find that it's their authenticity that really connects me. You can never in anything in life escape the necessity of humanity to be present in an experience.
It's very hard to be in the now when we have everything at our fingertips.
Yeah. It's anxiety producing. It really is. But there are things that that I don't find titillating and exciting. I don't want to see everything that everybody's eating. I'm not that hungry.
Right. That's what Sam Edelman was saying. No more food porn.
Yeah, it's like I'm
useless words.
Yeah, but I agree with that. No more food porn. I don't mind seeing it if you're Marcus Samuelson or Bobby Flay, and I don't mind occasionally if you cook something really well or you cook something that's delicious for your friends. But I feel like people a lot of times don't know what to share about themselves in their life. Then you don't have to say anything that moment. You can wait until there's an authentic moment to share.
Take a pause.
Yeah.
Now, what are your thoughts then on filters, photo, face tuning, pictures?
I like anything that you can make look better. I mean, my whole life is about making things look prettier than they really are.
Right.
That, I don't think, is false, shockingly. I know that sounds, antithetical to what I just said. I think if the moment is real, you can fabricate how beautiful it was.
Right. So a little bit of filter to a sky or a little bit of smoothing to the...
I use it because I'm middle-aged and, I have bags under my eyes and I don't like wearing makeup and sometimes I didn't sleep. And
even with makeup.
Yeah, it's like, fine. I have to tell you, I used filters a lot more in the beginning, but I'm less likely to use them now. I do a lot of no filter stuff. It's just easier and it's real, but it doesn't offend me. It doesn't make me judge the moment.
Right, yeah. Well, there is a fantasy to fashion, right? I mean, there is a realism,
all fantasy.
Also a fantasy, right? There's street style to, the center of spread and bold.
It is all fantasy, but the reason that we're obsessed with it is because the two things we've spoken about tonight, fashion and food, there are two questions you ask yourself every day. What am I going to eat and what am I going to wear?
That's right.
And those are two things that are all consuming. We don't walk around naked and hungry.
Right.
We celebrate every day through a personal expression that you put on, that you wear, and we nourish ourselves. Our wellness, our health comes from the food we eat. And it's also a cultural and social experience.
Right. Another quick question I want to ask you is we tried to get you a little bit earlier.
Yes.
People stop you all the time.
Yeah.
Are people, wherever you go, wanting to get a selfie with you or Instagram or Twitter?
I will say that selfies with anybody who's recognizable have replaced the autograph. They are the new autograph for sure.
Right.
I bridge a generation. I'm not Jennifer Lopez famous, but I'm famous enough that people, sometimes in an airport want a picture of me or want they. But when I started in TV, people would ask for autographs still. Now they don't. Now they ask for selfies.
Right, that shift has happened.
Yeah, for sure.
Talking about wearable tech, talking about shifts happening.
Yes. I love anything that has multi-purpose, that bridges two worlds together. So I think that if it's wearable and it's technologically savvy and helps you live a easier life, I think that's great. I do. I mean, I really do. I'm not so sure that the watch format is the one that I find the most exciting, but I think that it's great to no longer have something in your hand. I feel like the watch is also the reason that it's becoming like the Apple Watch and the Android watches that everybody is so excited about. I feel like there's a social cue that we're missing when we're in real life, real time moments. Like you're at a table with somebody and you always have your phone in your hand. I feel like the watch allows you to kind of bury that a little, and you can glance at it, but you're not all consumed by it. So your anxiety, is reduced because you can look and say, oh, it's so-and-so, I'll text them later, or oh, it's so-and-so, I'll call them later. Whereas with a phone, you're constantly compelled to respond. I think that the kind of glance to a watch might actually restore the ability for us to be in present and in the now. Yeah. Yes. I mean, one of the things I see, and I don't know if it's actually next, is that because we control environments and climates coupled with global warming, that we are seeing a lot more layering and a lot more lightweight garments that allow people to really customize their personal thermostat based on whether they are a little hot or a little cold. People layer their clothes to find a comfortable temperature where they don't feel like the heat rising, or they don't feel their fingertips freezing. So I feel like that's one of the things I see in fashion, is that there's all these seasonless weight items in both seasons.
Right, lack of seasonality is really interesting.
Yeah.
And do you ever take social media breaks? It's my last question. Then
yes, all the time. My entire life is a social media break.
Really, though?
Yeah, I mean, I do it not with intention. I don't say I'm going to take a social media break, but I feel like sometimes I just don't have something to say, or I didn't like the picture, or I forgot to take the picture.
Right. You just don't
want to
be out there.
Yeah. So you just kind of, yeah. You just don't want to be out there. Yeah. So you just kind of miss, you know, you. I don't even want to say miss the opportunity, because that's not what it is. You just
pass
on the opportunity.
Yeah.
Exactly. Yes.
That was such a pleasure talking to you. Ditto.
That was fun.
This was amazing. And enjoy tonight.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Camera's right here. Thank you for joining us this evening.
Thank you, absolutely.
So beautiful.
Thank you.
So I love a pop of color. We haven't seen so much color tonight. How did you pick what you were wearing?
Well, you know, spring and summer's coming up, so I think, I know, everyone's happy about that. So, I don't know, I think coral's a great color to kind of, you know, look forward to spring and bring it in, so.
And then also, what about the inspiration for your hair and makeup?
Well, going for more of the slicked back, kind of sharp look tonight, so I guess it's a little
because
bit
because you have the high neckline.
Yeah, exactly. So,
do you get inspiration for style and for hair and makeup online?
Yeah, well, I actually have a stylist who kind of helps me out with that. So, but yeah, I actually look all the time for, you know, Instagram. Yeah, it's like for makeup, hair, anything like that. I think it's great for ideas.
Yeah. And so are you following anyone whose style you love, a brand or a person that you always look to?
Well, I'm actually, my shoes and my clutch are Christian Louboutin, and actually they're one of the nominees for the Instagram award, which I'm also announcing tonight, so yeah.
Everyone loves a Lube.
I know, right? The great shoes.
Those red bottoms, everyone loves them, men, women.
Yeah.
Okay, and so tell us, are you a selfie queen? And if so, what's your filter?
I'm not too big on selfies, but I do take them. I think my favorite filter is Sierra because it's a little bit more natural. It just kind of highlights your natural complexion and eye color. So.
And it's a warm filter,
yeah,
and so
exactly.
It gives you a little bit of
look like you used 8 filters and like retouching. It looks pretty natural, so I like that.
And is anything that you have on from your nail polish to hairspray, is anything you bought online?
No.
Nothing? No. Do you shop online?
I do.
You also had help with your stylist.
Yeah, I did. I did. Yeah, absolutely. I actually buy a lot of my jewelry online. I like actually Etsy.
Yes, we love Etsy.
They have like handcrafted jewelry and stuff, and I really think that's cool, and I like supporting like people that are kind of making a business for themselves. So.
And in terms of what you choose to share online, is there stuff that you're like, this is a perfect Instagram moment, or this is great for Twitter? Do you sort of like think of the different platforms?
Kind of, yeah. I'm more into Instagram than I am Twitter. But yeah, I try to think of like, oh, what can I do to put on my Twitter? Like, I try to like, you know, engage my followers and stuff. So sometimes I have a picture that's taken, or I take a picture, then I'm like, oh, I should put that on Instagram. But other times I'm looking for something like.
What about other platforms? Are you on Snapchat or Meerkat?
I'm actually not. A lot of people have tried to get me on Snapchat, but I'm already like have so much time taken up with everything else, so it's like.
Sort of hard to divvy your time across all the platforms.
Yeah, I'm having a hard enough time with Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, so I'm good on that.
Now, do you have any actual printed pictures that you have in your house, or is all your pictures sort of on your phone?
Currently on my phone, because I haven't been in my apartment that long. I definitely don't have any printed pictures of myself, but
friends or family. I find that no one's printing photos.
I have been bad about that lately, actually. But it's funny you say that, because I was thinking just last week that I want to, you know, frame some pictures, yeah.
And then what about wearable tech? Do you ever think you'd want to wear a ring that tells you if you have a text message?
Sorry?
Wearable tech, like rings that will alert you if you have a text message, or like Apple Watch. Like, are you...
No, actually, but...
Something that it interests you?
Yeah, I mean, I think it's a cool concept, but, I mean, I think the less things that I have to wear and use and hold, like, I have... You know, my cell phone that I have to watch out for, so
right.
I just keep everything on that.
You keep it simple.
Hopefully I won't lose it, because then I'd be screwed.
Right. Okay, well, it was great speaking with you. Thank you for taking time with us this
Absolutely.
Evening. Enjoy the show.
Thank you.
Okay, hi. Nice to meet you. Come jump in. This is our camera right here.
Right.
We're live streaming Fashion 2.0 red carpet.
All right.
Where did you get your inspiration for this look?
For this look,
texture play, pattern play.
Well, it's all Calvin Klein, and I've done a lot of work with them, and that's definitely where I got the inspiration from.
Okay. Do you do your own hair?
I do, yes, and I constantly get asked, "What do I use in it?" And I'll be honest, it's me, a lot of sweat, and actually today I came straight from the gym to here, so a little bit of a rush, but.
So you definitely didn't buy the sweat online, then. I can't ask my follow-up.
No, you know, I can't bottle it. You know. It's asking a little much.
Although sea salt spray, I guess, is people's attempt at bottling what you have naturally.
Yeah. You know, I'll admit, I've learned a lot of things from working on different jobs, different people, and sea salt spray, it tends to be a good one.
What about skin? I mean, are you learning a lot from stylists on set and groomers? Are you seeing Pinterest tips or men's health articles online or things like that?
Yeah, definitely. I definitely follow men's health style stuff. But when it comes to skin, I'm not a huge fan of the makeup on jobs. But I clean it off right away. But I will say that I keep it as natural as possible. I've always had the philosophy, as soon as you start using stuff, you'll need to continue to use it to look that way.
Yeah.
So I keep it all natural, maybe a little lotion in the winter, but that's about it.
And do you restock those sort of things like deodorant, lotion, cologne online? Do you shop online or in store?
I usually go in store, but occasionally I'll buy things online. Kind of like the boxes where they send you kind of a you never know what you're going to get type of thing.
Subscription boxes.
Yeah, subscription boxes. Sometimes I'll do that. Maybe not a subscription, but I'll go and buy the box.
Right. And do you get style inspiration from online? Like, do you look? Are you following a lot of people on your social feeds?
I actually follow zero people, but...
good for you.
Yeah.
You are then the style inspiration to others.
I guess so, yeah. I see a lot of it. You know, events like this, working. Definitely the fashionistas of the fashion world are the stylists and the hairstylists and even sometimes the photographers that you work with.
Right, the creative team, the crew.
The creative directors are the ones, and they bring a lot to the team, so I've definitely learned a lot from them.
So you sort of get a little bit of inside info from them and sort of make it your own then in your day-to-day life?
Yeah, you know, if they're working at the top, they're the best of the best, so I have to assume that.
Why not take their lead?
Yeah, their stuff has to be some of the best, so.
And then in terms of technology, do you want to wear your tech? I mean, do you want to get rid of your phone and have a watch that sort of tells you your tweets and texts?
Yes, for ease of like user-friendly ability. I'm excited for the Apple Watch. I'll probably pre-order it. I did with the iPhone 6, and I waited in line at Grand Central. But I'm not a huge tech nerd, but I look forward to the watch and being able to not have to pull my phone out of my pocket all the time to check something where I can just pull up a watch and look at it.
And even with social interaction, it's sort of the phones have become part of, you know,
the touch bar that you can send with people and interact. It's a very intimate thing, and I think it's trying to bring back that intimacy rather than, I think, what 2015 is becoming known as is people down with their heads craned down into a phone.
They have double chins by this time.
I know. They've done studies to show that it increases neck
lines. Oh, I know.
So now I try to, if I'm doing it, I keep my phone out here.
You know? Do the same. It's happening.
Yeah.
And then what about selfies? Are you sort of?
I'm told I should take more, strictly for social media. And yeah, but I don't take enough, no. No, I find it a little strange to hold a phone in front of my face and do that.
And if it was a watch or something else, it might be.
It would be, yeah. Cause it, well, maybe not, because then people might think I'm trying to, you know.
Oh, what time is it?
Time
it's
is
discreet.
It?
Yeah. So if you do any sort of selfies or photos of friends, do you filter them off or do you sort of manipulate? Are you one of those whizzes?
No, honestly, I think the only thing I do is I use an app to make it a square so it fits within Instagram. But so it fits nicely and it has kind of a matte border around it. So I take that a little bit from school. The whole artistic side. It's kind of weird because it cuts off parts of the picture. It's not full screen, it's widescreen. You know, I think of it that way. Yeah.
If you take a picture and it shows landscape, then maybe there's pieces that you don't want to cut
out. You don't want to cut that off, so you deserve to see it. Yeah, that's about it. I don't do much of the color stuff on it. Just keep it simple.
Cool. Well, I hope you enjoy the awards tonight.
Yeah,
thank you for taking time to chat with us.
Yeah, of course. It was very nice meeting you.
Nice to meet you. Pleasure to meet you.
Really nice to meet you.
Could you tell us a little bit about what you're wearing this evening?
Yeah, I'm wearing...
This is our camera right here, the live stream. Yes.
I'm wearing Aida, my dress, and a Nina clutch, and sequin earrings.
Love them. Love the earrings. I love the little iridescence to them.
Thank you.
Did you look to any social media for inspiration, or did it call to you?
Yeah, well, you know, I really love the color, and that's really my, you know, my first component that I look at. And then also fit. I love things that, you know, are really flattering for the body. So thank you. Thank you.
And what about your makeup? Did you decide,
Well, I thought the dress was so bold. I just wanted to keep the makeup kind of a neutral look and then a really fun ponytail to go with it. Thanks.
Recreate this hair. I'm assuming you had it done.
I did all my hair and makeup.
You
so
did? I assume that you did it because it looks so professional.
Thank you. I came straight from school, so.
Okay, well, you look great. So do you get tips and tricks from Pinterest and Instagram?
Absolutely. I'm actually a style blogger, too. I have a lifestyle blog, k.lee.com. And I kind
of.
Yeah, totally. So I definitely look at inspiration, though.
I'm sure you also give inspiration in terms of the looks that you put out on your blog.
Yeah.
What are your favorite hair and makeup looks right now?
Right now, I'm loving the ponytail. I'm loving fun, tussled updos. Nothing that looks like it's too done. Yeah, absolutely. And normally, I like to go for like a natural dewy glow every day, and it's kind of my go-to.
Flawless skin.
Oh, well, thank you.
And in terms of the style that you cover, your site, do you cover fashion? You're covering everything. So how do you find your not inspiration from others, but how do you find things that you think will inspire?
Well, I kind of look at what I wear in my day-to-day life and what I see other people wearing and what resonates with them, and then I interpret it in my own way. So, like, for instance, I just did a series on leggings and how they're, you know, you can make them look really chic, go from day to night, from your workout to your night event. So
how do you know know what's resonating with them? Do they comment? They let you know what they think?
Yeah, I actually have a really big following of high school girls my own age, and I talk to my friends, I talk to my peers. I also stay up to date with Teen Vogue's my favorite magazine and Vogue, and I just kind of, you know, look at the trends that are going on right now and what I like too.
And so you sort of came up in an age of social media. Do you ever take a break from it?
Absolutely. I've actually been trying to do that recently. I've been reading my book instead of my phone on the subway. I'm reading 100 Years of Solitude. It's amazing.
Love that book.
Yeah. I'm still trying to stay engaged and then also, you know, keep my...
Have continuity with your audience.
Absolutely.
And so in terms of selfies, do you take a lot of selfies? Are you filtering them up? Do people come to expect that from you?
Well, I do have to take a certain amount of pictures to showcase, you know, what I'm doing with my job as Miss Teen USA. I try and kind of keep it varied, though, so I'm not giving too many selfies. But, yeah, it's definitely more than I did in the past.
Right. But you mix it up with other content, so
absolutely.
It's interesting.
Right. Can't take pictures of this every day.
And do you look to others? Like, is there someone who you're always like, I can't wait to see what they have on their feed, whether it's your friends or celebrities or a brand?
Absolutely. Carly Kloss and Taylor Swift are kind of my two inspirations for almost everything, and I sometimes pretend that I'm also their friend. But
maybe you will be after this.
Hi, I love you and your style.
Oh, cool. Okay. So, and then the last thing we've been talking about a lot of people tonight is wearable tech.
Yes.
Watches, rings, do you want to know someone's tweeting you or texting you in real time?
You know, I think it's a really good idea. I feel like I would like to wear it for a couple of days, but then maybe take a break from it and take it off. You know, it's really good to stay disconnected but still connected. I guess taking a break so that you're not really wrapped up in the virtual world, because there's a whole world going on out there.
Right, and it's interesting because you've never had you've never lived in a world where we didn't tweet these things.
Absolutely.
Instagram selfies.
Yeah, and it's been good for me to really focus on what's going on around me too.
That's great. Congratulations on all your successes, and we're so happy to speak with you tonight.
Thank you. Nice to meet you.
Have a good time. Okay, everyone, we're heading in now to the live show. I hope you keep on watching. See who all the award winners are, best Instagram apps, best Twitter, and also what's new in wearable tech and everything else, where tech meets fashion, style 2.0, style fashion 2.0. Thank you, guys.
figure out when, what, and how I'ma let this come out of my mouth. Said it ain't gonna be easy, but I need to stop thinking, contemplating, be a man and get it over with, over with. I'm riding in my whip, racing to her place, talking to myself, preparing to tell her to her face. She opened up the door and didn't want to come near me. I said, what's up, baby? Please erase.
My confession, just when I thought I said all I can say, my shit goes aside. She got one of the way. It's my confession.
So gone, so gone.
What to do,
what to do?
Yes, I gotta give it part two of my
If I'm gonna tell it, then I gotta tell it all.
Damn, they cried when I got that phone call.
That I'm losing my best friend. I can't believe this could be the end. It looks as though you're letting go. And if it's real, well, I don't want to know.
I'm the hottest around. They'll know when they see you rolling them parlors around me.
I got a soldier.
With the top down, feeling the sounds quaking and vibrating your thighs. Riding harder than guys with the chrome wheels at the bottom, white leather inside. When them lanes be spitting at you, tell them don't even try to shoot at Michelle and kick it with Kelly or holla at B. You gotta be G's, you way out of your league.
We like them boys that be in them legs leaning. Open their mouth, they grill gleaming. That we're cleaning.
They always be talking that country slang. We like
beat the beat in the back beating. I see so low from that chiefin. I love how he keep my body screaming.
Screamin'.
A rude boy that's good to me with street credibility.
If your status ain't hood, I ain't checking for him. Better be street if you're looking at me. I need a soldier that ain't scared to stand up for me. Known to carry big things if you know what I mean.
Shook.
tried to avoid, but this thing was happening. Swallow my pride, let it ride and parted, but this body felt just like mine. I got worried, I looked over to the left, a reflection of myself. That's why I couldn't catch my breath. Oops, there goes my shirt up over my devoted so much time to find you unfaithful, boy. I nearly lost my mind. Drive past your house every night in an unmarked car, wondering what she had on me to make you break my heart. Yeah, I'm so gone. So
ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the 6th Annual Fashion 2.0 Awards. Please welcome your fourth-time host, TV personality, celebrity stylist, and one of the most prolific tweeters in fashion, Robert Verdi.
Yeah.
forgot to turn it on the other side. Okay, hold on. Okay, we'll do it later. Hi, everybody. Welcome to the 6th Annual Fashion 2.0 Awards. It is my fourth year hosting this wonderful extravaganza, which is a drag word that I like to use every now and again. Tonight, we are going to celebrate and honor some of the most prolific personalities and brands who have entertained, informed, and shared with us through a variety of their digital territories, from Instagram to Facebook and Twitter and beyond. I'm not sure what's beyond, although Periscope just launched. How many of you are on Periscope? Is anybody Periscoping now? Yes. Okay, one person is Periscoping. Okay, so before we get on with the show, we have a lot of shit to talk about. I don't know where to start. First of all, I don't want to break, the glasses are coming off. I don't know, I'm going to go straight to the most exciting thing to happen to fashion in the last 20 years. And her name is Cookie Lyons. Is she not the most delicious thing to happen to TV? It's beyond. First of all, let's keep it in check. She is part Sharon Stone in Casino. She's a little bit Roxy Roker. Do you guys even know who Roxy Roker is? Okay, stay with me. She's got a lot of Alexis Carrington Colby and a splash of Honey Boo Boo. And where I come from, that's a recipe for success. So I'm just saying, it's one of my favorite things that has happened in years. Now, I also want to get you guys on board. It's terrible to have a captive audience like this and not use our influence, our greater influence, to do good in the world. And I don't know if you guys heard about what's happening in Indiana with the Religious Freedom Act. I know, but we can do something about it. And I think we should start tonight a campaign. Where's Jason from my team? There, Jason, take this picture. We're gonna start a Twitter campaign similar to the ALS Ice Bucket Challenge. It's gonna be a little more aggressive. Ready? It's called Fuck You, Indiana. Fuck you, Indiana! Thank you. So we're gonna tweet that, and I want you guys to retweet it. I'm just saying, I'm saying something. Okay, so another not so real, and it's not really breaking news, but okay, let's talk about Bruce Jenner. It's all candy to me. First of all, if you're a guy and you hear his name, this is what you do. Because the very thought of it is painful. But since they are shoving Bruce down our throats, which will be impossible in a couple of months, if you know what I mean, I think we should use our collective power to help Bruce through this rebirth, and we can all help name him. So I've come up with a couple of names, and we can start a vote on Twitter and hopefully come up with a name that works. Because nobody wants to fuck a chick named Bruce. I mean, for sure. Okay, so here are some suggestions. Now, I'm just saying, come along for the ride, and let's get it out there. He could be a hashtag, and that hashtag would be Hey Girl Hey. I don't think it's a bad idea. I think it's very progressive. I think it's young, it's hip. I also think that the name Cookie is a great name. It's one of my favorite names. And then this is actually the one that I think might win, Him Kardashian. It's keeping up, you know, with the people who we know are never gonna go away, because the Kardashians are like herpes. They are here to stay. Oh, that's crazy. Can I also share this? This is kind of crazy. When they told me that this was gonna be at the Merkin Hall, I thought they said Birkin Hall, and I felt like Hermes had a theater, which I know is crazy, but that's what I told everybody. I'm like, it's at the Birkin Hall. Yeah, great gift bags. That's what I thought, but it's not really that true. Oh, Michael Phelps. He likes a warm pool. Did you guys follow that story? He likes getting peed on. I know. Do you guys read the newspaper? Didn't anybody tweet that? I mean, it's really crazy. Oh, and I totally don't agree with Dolce and Gabbana about that pricing. It's way too expensive. It's gotten crazy. Well, we have a lot of incredible presenters tonight and some fabulous nominees. But before we get started, let's welcome to the stage the CEO and founder of the Style Coalition and the Fashion 2.0 Awards, Yuli Ziv.
Oh, thank you, Robert. You never disappoint. It's such a pleasure. We're so lucky to have you as part of our Fashion 2.0 family, and you always make this event very memorable. Let me just take a breath and enjoy this moment, because I never get to enjoy this event. But, you know, I often get asked why I created this awards, and honestly, I don't have a clear answer. I still ask myself sometimes, what did I get myself into? But I guess it's part of the entrepreneurial nature, just see an opportunity and go after it without many doubts. And this is exactly what happened. It was just a fun social experiment that turned into this huge black tie event with VIPs, celebrities, red carpets, and press coverage by anyone from the Wall Street Journal to Vogue Japan. Thanks, Jonah. When we started, Fashion 2.0 felt like an underground movement. And I think today, it finally feels like mainstream. But the beauty of Fashion 2.0 Awards is really in its democratic fashion. From the nominees to winners, everyone is voted by the online community. And fans get a chance to really express their passion and love for those brands and designers they follow. And that's what's great about social media. You know, when we started these awards, we couldn't start them 10 years ago. There was nothing like social media. There was no Twitter, no Facebook, no Instagram. Think about it. Think about what we've built just in the last decade. It's pretty amazing. For me personally, without technology and social media, I wouldn't be able to build the company I've built and provide opportunities for more than 400 content creators and bloggers to build their own businesses, careers, and dreams. I feel very honored to be able to support this very talented group of people. I also feel honored to have my Style Coalition team behind me today, helping to put together this huge event. I couldn't list all of you guys because our team has grown so much this year. I wouldn't have enough time to do that, but thank you, everyone. I also feel honored to have all of you here in the room, some of the smartest and most innovative people in the industry who are not afraid to take risks and experiment in this new medium. Brands in this room have a combined audience of more than 400 million people. Think about the power you have in your fingertips. It is tremendous. You are able to reach 400 million people just by typing few words on your smartphone. Your power is in your influence, and I hope you make yours a positive one. Thank you, everyone. Don't forget to tweet and enjoy the show.
Presenting for Best Instagram is model Hannah Ferguson, best known for being chosen as one of the rookies for the cover of the 2014 Sports Illustrated swimsuit issue.
Hello, everyone. Since its inception, Instagram has been a disruptive force and an integral part of the social media revolution, allowing influencers to connect with the universe and instantly share powerful images and impact the culture, style, and fashion. Tonight, we are recognizing five unique brands which have utilized Instagram unlike any others. Tonight's nominees are Chanel, Christian Louboutin, Gap, Marc Jacobs, and Opening Ceremony. Drum roll. And the winner is Opening Ceremony.
Thanks so much. I'm Sue Barber, the art director of opening ceremony, and
I'm Philip, the director of e-commerce for opening ceremony.
And just a few words. Our founder, Umberto Leon, was an early adopter of Instagram himself, and he really pushed us from the moment we opened an account to try and figure out this new platform and use it in the most beautiful, creative, and engaging way to help tell the story of opening ceremony and all the brands we represent.
And just to add, you know, we're completely grateful to our community of collaborators, models, photographers, friends and family, who have all contributed to all of the images that we're being rewarded for tonight. Thank you.
Thanks.
Presenting for Best Facebook, Janice Ansons, top model who starred in campaigns for Gucci and Dior and has walked for Dior Homme, Louis Vuitton, and Jill Sander, and nabbing editorial work in V-Man, Details, Numero Homme, and here at Interview.
Hi, good evening, everyone. I'm here tonight to present the Best Facebook Award. Tonight's nominees have all done the incredible fashion digital work and are being honored tonight for their ability to really connect with their fans and with their audience. So the nominees are Burberry, Coach, Converse, H&M, and Michael Kors. And the winner is H&M.
Presenting for Best Pinterest, Lauren Drell. Lauren is the branded content director at Mashable, where she joined as associate editor in 2011. She helped scale their branded content division and now works with over 35 brands.
Hello. My notes just disappeared. Hold on one sec. Sometimes digital technology just fails us. Oh my God. I think I just archived it is the problem. This is so embarrassing. Crap. Okay, I'm just gonna wing it. So what I wanted to say is that Pinterest is a really interesting social platform because a lot of social platforms started out in the tech world and then sort of trickled to the mainstream. But Pinterest really started with all the creatives and the designers and all these super interesting fashion people and then moved into the tech world. And I actually had the chance to interview Evan Sharp, who's one of the co-founders of Pinterest and the designer of it, back in 2011, still in the early days. And we were talking about how Pinterest is a really interesting platform on which to discover things that you love. And it's not really a place to self-promote, which obviously makes it a bit of a tricky landscape for brands. But turns out that he felt very strongly that brands actually do have a place on Pinterest and said that it should be the idea behind the brand that really makes sense. You shouldn't be just pushing your products. You should be sort of crafting a lifestyle. So I think that these five nominees have done a really awesome job. Obviously, Pinterest is the fastest growing social network of all time, and it's become a huge revenue generator for brands. And I think everyone's really looking to these five for leading the way. So the nominees are Free People. Are there no visuals? Okay. Sorry. Everyone's having technical difficulties. J. Crew, Kate Spade, Michael Kors, and Nordstrom. And the winner is Kate Spade.
I remember the first night when our designers got together to launch our Pinterest page. We did Pinterest, pretzels, and Peronis. The whole design team and the creatives all got together and we pinned all of our inspiration, and it's still kind of the way we do things today. So thank you so much. And yes. Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Presenting for Best Twitter, Clark Bockelman, top model and the male face of Calvin Klein. He has graced the pages of V Magazine, CR Fashion Book, WWD, in a shot with star photographers David Sims, Mario Testino, and Bruce Weber.
All right, hello everybody. Tonight I will be presenting for the Best Twitter Award. Twitter is one of the greatest online networks that we use, and it's literally used by people all over the world. And tonight's nominees do an incredible job at connecting with people throughout their daily lives and keep the conversation of fashion going and keep it available to most of us in the world, rather than any way of telling us what they're thinking and is on their mind every second. They give us useful stuff. Tonight's nominees are Dior, DKNY, DVF, Marc Jacobs, and Victoria's Secret. And the winner is Dior. I just want to thank my mom and my dad and just everyone who got me here.
Presenting for Best E-Commerce is Danica Lowe, editor-at-large for Glamour.com. Danica is the author of the book How Not to Look Fat and has worked for more than a decade in the fashion industry.
So in preparation to present this award, I thought that it was my responsibility as a journalist to do some serious research, otherwise known as shopping this weekend. So here are this year's nominees, and my credit card company thanks you. They are ASOS, Farfetch, Free People, Nasty Gal, and Net-a-Porter. And the winner is Net-a-Porter.
I'd like to thank the Style Coalition for nominating Net-a-Porter for this award. On behalf of our amazing team, I'm honored to be here tonight to accept this award for Best E-Commerce. As many of you have heard, today was a big day for us at Net-a-Porter, and we're all really excited about the future. As Natalie Massenet, our founder and executive chairman, said today, the best way to predict the future of fashion is to create it. Congratulations to all the other nominees, and thank you for voting for us.
Presenting for Best Interactive Retail is Brooklyn native Marielle Bobo, fashion and beauty director at Ebony Magazine.
Hello, everyone. So in today's ever-evolving digital landscape, technological advancements have redefined the way that we think about the modern shopping experience. The brands in this category wowed us with groundbreaking innovations built on optimizing the retail experience. And the nominees for Best Interactive Retail are Bloomingdale's Holiday, Burberry and Printemps, Calvin Klein and Macy's, Nike Fuel Station, and Rebecca Minkoff. And the winner is Rebecca Minkoff.
I'm the SVP of e-commerce and omnichannel marketing at Rebecca Minkoff, and I just want to say thank you. Thank you to everyone who voted for us. This means a tremendous amount to all of us. I'm also saying thank you on behalf of Uri and Rebecca and Elisa, our group president. As you can see up here, if you haven't had a chance to go to our store, please do, but it's a sincere labor of love, and we really appreciate all your recognition. Thank you.
Hi, everyone. 30 years ago, I know this is hard to believe that I could do anything 30 years ago, I worked for Bloomingdale's in the Short Hills Mall. I was raised in a mall by salespeople. My parents used to just drop me off and, you know, they'd come pick you up 3 days later. But I sold shoes, and I put myself through school, through FIT, selling shoes, and one of the brands I sold was Sam and Libby. And that brand was created by the brilliant Sam Edelman. And so tonight, Sam is going to join us to give us our keynote. Please welcome the creative, visionary, and legendary Sam Edelman, founder, designer, and president of the Sam Edelman division of the Brown Shoe Company.
Thank you for that introduction, but I have to begin by saying that my wife Libby, who's sitting with me, my partner and my co-founder of everything I've done in my career. I thought it was interesting that I got invited to speak tonight because maybe I'm not one of the most technologically advanced people in the world. As a matter of fact, I was using a flip phone a year ago. It's really true. Preparing for this has been totally enlightening for me. And I realized that actually I'm not a bad choice because what I do every day is live, eat, and breathe the 80 young women that work with me in our business. And those 80 young women live on their phones. And I've learned so much from them, and I use it in everything that I do. I guess the things that I do every day are maybe a little bit different. I don't look for a boyfriend online. I don't take funny pictures of myself with my lips looking like a duck. And even though I love lobster risotto, I find it very hard to take a picture of it and share it with my friends. Just kind of like not my thing. Maybe I'm learning more and more every day about this new part of our life. But the true thing is that I'm a fashion designer. And I've been a fashion designer for a very long time. And the entire world is changing so quickly, and I've had to adapt. It used to be that, quite honestly, I would go to Europe 4 times a year. I'd walk the streets of Europe, and I'd really think I was a genius. I would discover something on the the Champs-Élysées, Bond Street, you name it in Europe, and I would take it and I would interpret it, and I would come out with an amazing collection, and everybody would say, God, he's a genius. It's amazing what he's done, what Libby and he have done. That's just incredible. But today, what I see in Europe, my customer has already seen. She sees it live stream from the fashion shows. The bloggers are telling her. Everyone's telling her what's happening. So I've had to totally adjust. I've had to completely change. And it's forced a whole nother level of creativity, of speed. And actually, I think it's made us so much better. But it's hard. It's really hard. I think that being here tonight and hearing that we have the ability to touch 400 million people, it just wakes me up to the fact that I and my team, the 80 young women that I work with, my family, et cetera, we have the opportunity to grow our business so, so dramatically over the next couple of years. I want to congratulate everybody that's been nominated tonight. I reviewed all your work before I came. I think it's amazing. And I want to thank everybody that invited me. Good luck.
Presenting for Best Digital Philanthropy is 2008 Miss Universe Diana Mendoza, who spent her year-long reign traveling the world to speak on humanitarian issues and to promote education regarding HIV and AIDS.
Good evening. The nominees for the Best Digital Philanthropy are Dressember, Kate Spade on Purpose, Kenneth Cole, Look Good for Good, Michael Kors, Watch the Hunger Stop, and Ralph Lauren, Pink Pony Fund. And the winner is Dressember.
Wow, this is really cool. You guys look great from up here. My name is Blythe Hill, and I'm the president and founder of the Dressember Foundation. And a lot of you are probably wondering what that is next to all those other really recognizable nominees. So it's really cool to be honored among those. The Dressember campaign is a month-long campaign where women wear a dress every day in the month of December, and we raise awareness for anti-human trafficking organizations and anti-sexual slavery organizations. And in 2 years, we have raised over $600,000. We have, yeah. Thanks. We have participants in 35 countries, and it's just growing at a rapid pace. And it's exciting to be here tonight because one of my goals in restoring dignity to women and girls worldwide is to do so within the fashion industry as well, from modeling to transparent and ethical production. So I hope that you will all join me in the fight for dignity within fashion and start a fashion revolution. Thank you so much.
I'm very lucky I get to present two awards. This is going to be the Best Online Video Award. The nominees are Chanel.
Once upon a time, Coco Chanel chose her lucky number as the date for her first runway show, February 5th, 1954. Sitting unseen at the top of the famous staircase on the Rue Cambon, she watches as her models parade in utter silence. The French press tears her apart, ridiculing her designs and sneering at her age. Once upon a time, America soon discovered and embraced the style of Chanel. Life, the most read magazine in the United States, writes, at 71 years old, Gabrielle Chanel brings more than a style, a revolution. Coco Chanel regains her influence and once again impresses her style upon the world.
Spade exactly where my keys waiting are. Game.
Nicole Miller, Fashion Winter 2014. And Rag and Bone Man, Fall Winter 2015. Featuring Barinishkov and Dilbuck. And under Armour, I will what I want. And the winner is Under Armour, I Will What I Want.
Thank you very much. As the creative director of Under Armour Women's, it's incredible to be here being recognized as a fashion brand tonight, so thank you for that. And of course, the most thanks go to Giselle, who was an exceptional partner and continues to be, I think, an inspiration to many of us in the industry and beyond. Thanks.
For a special tribute to the former 2.0 designer nominee, Oscar de la Renta, please welcome model and author, Carol Ault. Carol has been referred to as the face. She's been the face of numerous campaigns, including CoverGirl, and has been on the cover of more than 700 magazines, including Vogue, Elle, Glamour, Harper's Bazaar, and Sports Illustrated.
Jeebus, all I can think of is Giselle is old, I must be really ancient. And Lauren from Pinterest, you know, I come from a generation where I can't lose my speech on a cell phone, so I'm just gonna speak about Oscar off the cuff, as we say in the fashion industry. There's not much I can say about Oscar that you don't already know. He was elegant, yes. He was suave and debonair, yes. He was Dominican and actually born in the Dominican Republic, yes. He was one of seven children, most all of which were girls except for him, so he had six Barbie dolls to dress since he was a young boy, which of course led to such an incredible career. But I wanted to give you a small story that might illustrate who Oscar really was. I was just a young little greenback off of Long Island, the daughter of a fireman. My first job was with Oscar. He hired me to do the opening of Japan. It was one of the first designers in the land of the rising sun. And I said, Oscar, but I've really never done a show before. I've never walked in front of anybody. And he said, don't worry about it. My girls are all very seasoned experts, and they will take you under their wing. And I'm sure he had a lot of fun watching me. I was kind of like a little puppy who kept missing the wee-wee pad. You know, I did everything wrong, but I was very enthusiastic. And the very first show we did was supposed to start in the dark. We were supposed to walk out and take our positions on the stage, and Pat Cleveland and I were supposed to enter from opposite sides. And just before the lights go up, as it's starting to get light on the stage, my rug gives way, and I do a mambo down seven steps and land on my feet at the bottom. And I look up to Oscar, who's behind stage with this look of horror on his face, his hands on his head, his mouth hanging open. And all I could think was, oh my God, I just ruined this guy's show. So I waited for Pat to walk down. I looked at Pat. I walked off stage and I went behind the stage and Oscar came running over and I thought, okay, I'm fired. He's gonna send me back to New York with my tail between my legs. And he started laughing. He said, that's the most hysterical thing I'd ever seen. It would have been funnier if I didn't think you might have been hurt. Are you okay? And I'm like, oh my God, I thought you were gonna fire me. He goes, fire me? That's the best time I've had in years. And I said, you know, here's a guy who has everything on the line. He's opening Japan. He's the first fashion designer there. And these are his shows, which shows his line. And when I went down those stairs, all he could think about was, I okay? That to me is heart. That to me is true elegance, of which Oscar was a premier example. I'm also going to give the nominees for the online campaign. They are, thank you, Aerie for Real, DKNY for Cara DKNY, French Connect for hashtag can't help my selfie, Marc Jacob, that's a cute name, yeah, Cast Me Mark, and Tiffany and Company, Will You? And the winner is Marc Jacobs, Cast Me Mark.
Thank you, C-Flow. So thank you guys. This is an honor. A lot of time, a lot of care goes into this, a lot of love. Some of you may read the news. The future for us is unwritten in terms of Mark by Mark, but you know, we're gonna continue to push the boundaries, and like Yuli said, it's about taking risks. And you know, this was you know, this means a lot to us, the team, and we have some new leadership, and I'd like to thank Sarah Choi, who just joined us, and here's to the future.
Thank you, Mark fam.
Yeah.
Let's give a warm hand to Max Berlinger, who is currently the senior editor at details.com.
Presenting Best Wearable Tech, and the nominees are Intel for opening ceremony, Motorola Moto 360, Rebecca Minkoff for Casemate, Ringley, and Tory Burch for Fitbit. And the winner is Tory Burch for Fitbit. So Tory Burch for Fitbit.
How you gonna do it if you really don't wanna dance? By standing on the wall.
Get your back up off the wall.
Tell me, how you gonna do it if you really don't wanna.
Presenting the best fashion startup is Jessica Lawrence, the executive director for the New York Tech Meetup Group, which consists of 40,000 plus members. She's also a writer, a speaker, a Seth Godin FEMBA grad, and a blogger for the Harvard Business Review.
Thank you. I'm really happy to be here representing the New York tech community. You are all the best dressed tech audience I have ever had the pleasure of addressing. And it was funny, I was in the office earlier today talking to my team about the fact that I was coming here tonight, and my two male team members promptly got into a debate about the comparative breathability of cotton versus merino wool hoodies. So An interest in fashion is definitely alive and well in the tech startup community, as is evidenced by the amazing companies that are nominated for this award tonight. So the nominees for Best Startup are Cosmic Cart, Latote, Spring, True and Company, and Twice. And the winner is Cosmic Cart.
I'll say we've come a long way from mom's basement to red carpet here tonight. So we just got these suits like a week ago. So.
Yeah. Tell a kind of a funny story. I was at Magic Marketplace, was my first interaction with the fashion scene. I laid out all my nicest clothes with my mom, and we ultimately picked a few clothes. We went there, and there's like 50,000 of the most, you know, the best dressed people you've ever seen, and I was the 50,000th worst best. So I ended up throwing on my startup t-shirt and just like going back. So I've thus graduated to a suit. Thank you very much. It's an absolute honor to receive this award from our peers, from our clients. I can't thank you all enough. We'd like to thank our team, investors, advisors, and we're looking to work with the boldest, most innovative brands as well. This only works if you all want it to. So thank you very much. Look forward to working with you.
Presenter of the Visionary Award is Grace Atwood, the founder of TheStripe.com and one of the original employees of BaubleBar and former social media director.
I've been a part of BaubleBar from the beginning, and it's been so rewarding and fun to watch Amy and Daniella launch the company and grow it into the successful brand it is today. They are so incredibly passionate about, what they do, and every day they work very hard to bring a little bit of sparkle into people's lives around the world. I'm so grateful for their vision, and I really admire how they've built such an inspiring team and a fun brand. This brand resonates with so many people all around the world. They could not be more deserving of the Visionary Award, and it's my absolute pleasure to present it here tonight to Amy Jain, co-founder of BaubleBar.
Everyone, so much for this wonderful honor. When Danielle and I were quitting our jobs 4 years ago to launch BaubleBar, I think the thing we were most nervous about was being pretty much complete outsiders to the fashion industry and community. Honestly, ever since day one, everyone has really welcomed us with open arms, and I feel like everywhere we turn, we have all these supporters and folks rooting for us, and it really means so much to the two of us. This award is a perfect example. We all work so hard building our businesses, and it has nothing to do with the recognition, but I think for the two of us, hearing that others think we're onto something and it's not just in our heads definitely is a great feeling. Thank you so much to Yuli and Style Coalition for this incredible award, and to all of you for all the support and encouragement over the years. It means so much to our team. Thank you.
Presenting for Top Innovator is Erica Domasek, founder of PS I Made This, an innovative lifestyle brand. Erica is the author of two global bestsellers, PS I Made This and PS You're Invited. Her creations have been featured in Vogue, Elle, InStyle, Lucky, and The Wall Street Journal.
Hi. It's really funny hearing your bio on a speaker. Hi there. This is the exciting time of the night, the last award of the night, so I know everyone's probably hungry. I brought snacks, but I don't think a kind bar between everybody will get that far. But I actually did not prepare anything, shocker to those people who know me, but I was on my phone on Instagram on the way here,
And I happened to notice it was National Crayon Day. I'm sure everybody here knows that as well. You probably think, where is she going with this? And I was thinking about coloring. I was looking at the crayons, and I started searching on the hashtag. And when I think about coloring, I think about three things. I think about there are three types of colorers. Is that a word, colorers? Now it is. There you go. But in all honesty, there are three different types of people. And I think that there are the type of people who stay inside the lines when they color. And then there are the type of people who color outside the lines a little bit. And then there are the people who do not see any lines whatsoever. These are the people who are, in my mind, not messy, but geniuses. These are the people who are innovative. These are the people who tonight, as silly as it sounds, these are the innovators who don't see any lines and have broken boundaries season after season, year after year, no matter what the emerging technologies may be. So tonight's nominees are DKNY, Kate Spade, Marc Jacobs, Michael Kors, and Rebecca Minkoff. And I think everybody here in the room can say there's not one of these brands who does not deserve to win this award. From digital to physical, they continue to innovate not only consumers, but just our peers. So the winner is Rebecca Minkoff.
That she's more my height, so this is friendly. Thank you. Yeah, because before I was like, wow, I am that short. So I'm going to keep my remarks short because I recognize I have one of the biggest honors, which is to release you to go get a drink, which is really important. But thank you again, honestly, from all of our hearts. This means a tremendous amount. And I also want to thank our consumer, because at the end of the day, we couldn't have done this fully integrated, what I like to call an ecosystem, without her. She's been with us on every single part of the journey. And as I like to say to my team all the time, we are in perpetual beta mode. So every day is a new day for all of us. And that's a thrilling and exciting ride to be on. And I really appreciate this award on behalf of myself and our entire team. So thank you and enjoy the beverages.
I got it right this time. Okay, so before we say goodnight, I want to say that earlier tonight we gave out a couple of awards. You know how they do that at the Emmys? So best Grindr hookup story went to someone. And what are you, the LinkedIn sponsored, what are you really the CEO of, was also given out earlier. I love LinkedIn, because everybody's looking for a job, but they're the CEO, right? They're like, what are you the CEO of? The CEO of your bathroom? And desperate to find work! Earlier tonight, I also want to just touch on this. A lot of people were asking me about Fashion Police, which has become Fashion Police. And I did do that show 10 years ago. Some of you may be too young to remember that, but the first time Joan Rivers made an exodus from Fashion Police on E, I was the lucky replacement. And it was a ride of a lifetime for a couple of years. And then Joan came back and replaced me after a series of other people. And of course, you know that we lost Joan Rivers, which I have to tell you is I feel absolutely awful about. Because all that plastic is in the environment now. But, you know, that is a difficult seat to sit in, and I wanna just say that that show was never, ever supposed to be called Fashion Police. It should have been called The Joan Rivers Show, because that's what that show was. There is no replacing Joan Rivers. And it is a very, very difficult line to walk, to be an insider in the fashion industry and really understand style and report on it, to
the world and celebrate all that is great that's happening on the red carpet. And obviously, Pachuliana Rancic is not the one who can do it. And with that, kids, congratulations to all our winners. I hope you had a good time. Please join me upstairs so we can toast and talk shit about each other.